Okay, we'll continue with figures. So let us, we had skipped a few slides because they were going out of the margins. So let us go back to this. Let's go back to the slide about the figures. Because the font sizes were made larger, it was going out of the page. And in Beamer, in which the slides have been made, that's also on LaTeX only. There, it doesn't automatically go from this page to next page. Yeah. So we'll say these environments are, in some sense, not so easily flexible between each other. So in the figure environment, there is a T for top of the page, B for bottom of the page, P. There is an option P for separate page for floats. So we don't want two floats to come on the same page. H for here, wherever the command has appeared in the source in the text file, it will come there. It will maintain the same sequence. An exclamation mark for override LaTeX internal parameters. The internal parameters are for good position, but you override them. Yeah, why? Because you might, in your discretion, decide that it has to be here by hook or crook. In that sense, you are overriding LaTeX internal parameters for good positioning. So one can also give captions to the figure. One can give it labels. You can give a label to a figure or a table, and you can refer to it. In that sense, LaTeX is a markup language. You can do a lot of cross referencing between figures, between tables, between sections, chapters. In fact, perhaps if you use PDF LaTeX, it also becomes clickable. Now let us have a look. Let us look at this figure. We have to LaTeX it two times. So, for example, so right now what you see here, you can do a good amount of cross referencing by making another number to come at a specified place. Now this is, this happens to be a reference, yeah. So whatever has come in square brackets, that is by convention the reference in a bibliography. And perhaps you will like that when you click on this, you will go to that reference directly. You might want that the PDF file has internal links, not just that it shows number 2 here and the number 2 there is indeed that particular reference, but when you click on this, it should go there. Yeah, these things are also possible. Yeah, using a package called hyperref. If we had done in the very start, use package. I do not know if it is there on this computer, but let us quickly LaTeX it and see. So it is not there. That is why it is giving an error. But if you use that particular package, if you use this package which I have commented out, because on this particular computer it is not there, if you use that, then you can also click on a particular reference and it will go to where it is defined, to the label. In that sense, not just for visibility purposes, even you can actually click inside and interlink these. In that sense, it is a markup language. So let us go to the next slide. So figures like tables are all floats, they will be auto numbered. If you put a caption, then they will also give a number and the caption will appear there. Table is for the same purpose. We already saw using tabular, we did not put a table, begin table, end table environment around it. In that sense, I think it was not a float, it would appear wherever we put it. But for bigger tables, we also have to allow it to be a float. We also might want to give a caption. Also, the caption should come in the list of tables in the first or second, third page of a report. So that is done by specifying begin table, end table environment, and specifying again T for top, B for bottom, C for center. That is when you can give a caption, label, etc. The table will then have a number. Yeah, let's go back to our present slide and see present document and see that the table doesn't have a number. The tabular environment, the tabular has made this into a table, but there was no place where we could give the table a name. We could not give a table number. So why don't we specify begin table? This begin tabular, end tabular, we have put inside a begin and end table. Now it becomes a float. You can specify caption here, tables caption here. You can also give a label. Tab label. Now it has given a label. It's given a table caption here. It's given a number to the table. Has the table caption come above the table only because we put the caption above? Let us see. That has something to do with the table environment. Let's put it below here. The same thing can be verified for a figure also. Now the table caption has come below. Yeah. To the best of my understanding, I think it is a convention to put the for tables to put the caption above and for figures to put the caption below. So wherever you put the slash caption, that table caption will come there. In any case, it will get that label, that number. That label will get that number, and you can also cross reference that. So let's go to the next slide. We can get the list of tables, list of figures by just this command. Wherever you put it, the table of list of tables will get generated and be put there in the final document. Now coming to this important topic called typesetting math. Many of the equations, many of the questions on chat I see are about this. So any mathematical symbol, mathematical mode is between two dollar signs. Yeah. So dollar sign, if you use, the first dollar sign that comes is the beginning of a math mode. The second dollar sign is where it ends. In the middle only you are allowed to use various math symbols. You can also use slash round bracket, slash round bracket. First one open, second one close, for starting math mode and ending math mode respectively. Yeah. So this is one other way to go into math mode, but dollar is easier in my opinion. So this is what is very useful for having mathematical symbols in line. In line, what is in line about it? In regular text, while you are reading, it will just continue in that line. It will not open it in a new line called equation. It will continue. We will see the difference of these both. But many symbols are available by using AMS Math. AMS stands for American Mathematical Society. They have plenty of symbols, plenty of fonts. And those all are available as use pack by using the package AMS Math. So we can see a quick demo about this. We can also see matrices. So B matrix is the default for defining a matrix. B matrix will work very similar to a tabular environment. Yeah, columns are separated by ampersand and double line, the slash for starting the next row. Instead of, so B matrix and other matrices, what is the exact difference, we will see using an example. So let us come back to this. This is example of math mode, alpha x, x cube. Yeah. So all these alpha, beta are all just straightforward. You can type slash alpha and you can be sure that it will be alpha equal to 89. Yeah. If you do this, let us also, let us compile this and see what happens. So it has created this alpha x cube beta superscript. I said super hat for superscript, underscore for subscript, alpha beta equal to 89. How much spacing to leave here? These are all default in math mode. If extra spaces here in math mode, spacing is extremely different. Yeah, please note, as soon as you are between in the math mode, you can go into math mode by a variety of ways. Yeah, one of the ways is to put it between two dollar signs. They are the same. We can see that by just repeating this and replacing the dollar signs by open round bracket and close round bracket preceded with a slash. So it will turn out to be the same. Yeah. So here, notice that all these spaces we put did not cause any space here. In the math mode, spaces are a different ball game. Yeah. Always note, inside the math mode, spaces are always ignored. Keeping that in mind, if you want a space, you have to use a different mechanism. Yeah, why? Because to make mathematical equations readable in plain tech, in just tech, you have to leave enough spaces, and you don't want it actually to affect the equations. So let us see what is the difference between inline. So these both are inline. If you remove this double slash, it will come inline. But you might also want this to be an equation. That time you will use square bracket. Yeah. So if you enclose it between square brackets, then it will become a separate equation. So notice that this has got repeated two times because I removed the double slash, and that is why it is inline. Yeah. But as soon as you encounter it between square brackets, slash, that is another way of going to math mode. These are all math mode. Because it is math mode, q raised to 3 works. Raised to 3 works here, here, it works here, it works here. Not just that, alpha, beta, these are all symbols for the math mode only. Yeah, if you don't put, if you write a slash alpha and don't put a math mode, you will not get alpha, you will have an error. But then what is inline about this? It is continuation of text. You can have some text after this also. Unlike this, where this is equation, only that this equation does not have a number. How to put a equation, how to put a number to this equation, that also we will see. But I hope everybody appreciates the difference between inline equation, inline math mode, and math mode that is completely a line. So let us instead of this, we can also say begin equation. This will make it into a, these are two separate things I am doing together. We have some continuation of text, but then when you do begin equation, then you have suddenly become, you have gone to math mode, but not in line math mode. Now it is a separate line, not because there is an empty line here. You can remove this line if you doubt that. Yeah. So now let us see what happens. This is an example of math mode. There is continuation of text here, that is the significance of inline. Then we have said begin equation, end equation, that is why this has come as separate line. Of course, it came as separate line even when you enclose this between square brackets, but that time the number had not come. Equation number has come because you use begin equation, end equation. And by convention, equation numbers are put between round brackets. Yeah, even when you refer to them, you have to put them between round brackets. You can give a label to this. Equation 1. Yeah, instead of 1, you can also call it 100 and 1100. No, you don't have to choose the right number. And then you can refer to this number. Suppose equation what have we done? We have given it a label and we have referred to that label. Here that number 1 has come, we gave the label only now, equation was there from before, but the label we gave only now, and of course immediately it does not know what number to put there, because first time it was compiling it had the number had not yet got generated to that label. So, when you LATEX it a second time, then the numbers have come correctly. Yeah. So, whenever you see question marks, that is because some labels have been redefined or were not defined before the first time, second time they will indeed come in into the document. How do I have multiple equations? Begin equation, okay, as I said, you can always disable the numbers by using star, right. Of course, in that case you should not be putting labels, but you can disable this number by putting a star. We already saw one method by which you will have it in equation mode, sorry, not here. If you put a star here, then it will disable the numbers. This is also a way of disabling the numbers. See, number 1 has not come here, but then if that label has not got a number still you are referring to it, then some question marks are inevitable. Yeah, if you do not want the number, you had better not be giving a label. The fact that you gave a label means you require that number. So, whenever you are going to refer to that particular label, it will give a question mark. Then you should not be putting a star, but we are more concerned with more number of equations, equation array. We can have new more equation, another frac phi times slash frac for fraction. Beta, gamma. So all these are extremely readable. Now for alpha, you always will type it as ALPHA alpha, yeah, equal to 56 subscript x. So it says begin equation. Some there's some spelling mistake in equation array. So please ensure that. Please ensure that when you LATEX, it should always come back to the prompt. So, here it has two equations 1 and 2, yeah, equation array, and notice that we did not put this in curly bracket, that is the only 5 has gone as a subscript, 6 has not gone as a subscript. This has also created fractions, 5 by 6 was one fraction, beta by gamma was another fraction. This question mark is coming because we are still referring to a label which is not there anymore, or maybe the it was there, but we did not compile twice. So, we can do that now. So, now that equation has come, that number, the first label referred to this equation. If you want this number 2, you have to use a separate label now. Yeah, the first one has already come. Label second equation. Please give meaningful labels. It's a good practice to do that. You can give, you can ref, so the second label can also be referred somewhere inside this. You can refer to when you have multiple equations inside multiple lines of equation. That is when you will use EQN array, equation array. That time you can refer to different numbers. This is where often you might say you want multiple lines of equations, but you want to give a, you want to give a number to only one of them, not to all, or maybe there is one line of equation to which you do not want a number. Yeah, there might, if you do not want for any of them, of course you can just do star to the whole thing. You can do star here, you can use star here, then numbers is disabled for everything. But if you do not want only for the second one, number is generated whether you give a label or not, you can also slash no number. Slash no number means that equation will not get a number. Yeah, if you are not giving that equation number, better do not even refer to that. Yeah. So, now the second one does not have a number, but each line is still an equation. I hope this answers the particular question that had come on chat. Somebody has said please show the code for a few seconds after showing the output. It will be hard for us to do this. These slides are all available and it is all there inside the slides. Yeah, it would take too much time to and what would you work after the sessions if you wait for so long with the code visible. Yeah, we want to go a little fast about this, and the coordinators will appreciate that we finish the entire LATEX in 1.5 hours during the coordinators workshop. We are already going extremely slow. To go slower is not a good idea. The idea of LATEX is when you need it, you will look up for the net, for information on the net. Let us see how to build a matrix. Yeah, that is important. As it says, you will use B matrix, but matrix is built only in the math mode. So you will say A equal to begin B matrix end B matrix. Yeah. Whether you leave for readability, it is best to put them on separate lines. Somebody said that they are not getting the correct output for frac. You see, frac we will do in little more detail. For now, slash frac. Frac requires two arguments. First argument is the numerator, second argument is the denominator. Each argument should be between curly brackets, like any arguments to a command in LaTeX. Let us come back to begin matrix, end matrix. So, here it is understood the number of rows, number of columns is decided automatically by the number of ampersands. Yes, 6 alpha. 6 beta. Yeah, to say that these are separate columns, you have to again separate them with ampersands. Now for new row, double line. New one might be gamma frac 4 by 5 is two arguments to the command frac. First one is 4, second one is 5. E pi. Yeah, this is how you build a matrix. Let us compile this and see. Also, since you started the math mode, you should also end the math mode using a dollar. So, this is how this we have defined. We forgot to put an ampersand here, that is why it has put 4 by 5 times E all inside the same entry. The B matrix is what decides that this should be square brackets. Yeah, square brackets is getting decided by this. One ampersand was less, that is why the last one has been left blank. Not a good practice to do this. Let us correct this. Ampersands will what is what tells that it is the next column now. Here I put an ampersand between 4 by 5 and E. And hence E has got shifted to the next column, and hence pi is the last one. So pi, if you read it as pi pi, so slash pi is a symbol, alpha, beta, gamma. So notice that constructing a matrix is extremely easy. It was never easier, one should note. Of course, this is inline. Yeah, it is inline because we use a dollar symbol. Yeah, one can have continuation of text here. Yeah, perhaps some text already here. We have put some text before the dollar sign, we have put some text at the end of the dollar sign, right. We have to save the file. So, we will come as continuation. For matrices, this is not good, but at least you will notice that more space has been left between consecutive lines because this is coming a little low. Yeah, so if you want it to be instead of dollar, you can put again the same thing applies. Yeah, how did this become a separate line in itself? It became a separate line instead of in line because we replaced the dollar with this and this. Why this? Because we didn't want an equation number. If you wanted a equation number, you will use begin equation, end equation, or begin equation array, end equation array. Equation array can also be used when you have only one equation. If you want to disable the number there, you can just put a star. Yeah, that's easier. Suddenly, if you decide that you don't want the numbers, star is the easiest rather than replacing begin equation by slash square bracket. Okay, let's go back to the slides. So as I said, B matrix is what decides that it should be a square bracket opening and square bracket closing for the equation itself. You might want to make a matrix without these square brackets. Yeah, that time you will just use begin matrix. P matrix for round bracket, capital B in the B matrix for curly brackets, just vertical for determinant. For example, we just use vertical line. So slash. Yeah, I hope this is visible. So these are the different begin, instead of begin B matrix, we can use these different things. Okay, so we go to the next slide. Subscripts and superscripts we have already seen. You can have subscript of subscript, superscript of superscript. You can have a subscript of superscript. Plenty of this is possible. There is no end. There is no limit. Yeah, like somebody has noted, for enumerate there you can do only 4 or 5, but for subscript superscript there is no end. Any number is okay. The subscript superscript have the obvious meaning when you use it with some commands like sum, integration. Whenever you do summation, you are always summing from something up to something. When you are integrating, you are integrating from something up to something. That time the lower and upper limits are also specified using these symbols. Yeah, upper limit by superscript, lower limit by underscore. Yeah, similarly for integration. So slash sum for summation sign, slash int for integral. That time these symbols have that obvious meaning, from where up to where, summation from where up to summation till where, integral from where up to where. Yeah, display equations are the other type of displaying math. Yeah, you can also display equations. AMS math has a number of environments. Yeah, there are some small subtle differences. We already saw this. If you don't put the star, you get the numbers. In equation array, you can also have some alignment. Yeah, we saw a place where there was only one entry in each equation, but one can also have some ampersands inside the equation array. That is very useful. If you have multiple equations and you want all the equality signs to be aligned, yeah, often we do some big set of calculations and we say equal to this in the next line, again equal to the next line. That is when you also want some alignment. That time equation array is the right thing to do. Fractions, we already saw. Fraction is a command that takes two arguments. First one is numerator, second one is denominator. The numerator denominator themselves can be fractions. Yeah, so each numerator, you can, in place of numerator, you just put superscripts, subscripts, whatever is required. Square root, we just put square root sign above something. If inside the square root, if you want some particular symbol, then you can use an option argument called n. Yeah, this is something we can see again here. Square root of x. So it is a good idea to say in math mode, not x. Because this is math mode, it should be in dollar sign, otherwise there will be an error. Or if you want the two, of course that is default, but you might want to say it. Yeah, after square root we know is or cube and cube root of x is. So for each we have so many, we cannot keep inventing different commands, right? So please read. You can also make this visible along with the PDF file. Please hold on. This is what we typed, and the output has come here on the screen. The square root of x. Notice that because we put in between dollars, this x has come like this. This is what x would come without math mode. Yeah, so it's always a good idea that if you are using the x in math mode, then you should write it between dollar signs whenever you require it. That is when it will put this x, yeah, and not just this x without the dollar signs. Without the dollar signs, it will give a regular Roman font x is by square root of x. Whether if it is only one letter under the square root sign, then you can choose to not put the square curly brackets. Yeah, this is just like some other weird syntax TT, I think. There also you don't need the square curly brackets if there is only one letter for which you want the square root sign. If there are many, then you have to put it in curly brackets. Yeah, so notice that these both have the same effect, only because we didn't use the curly brackets and there was only one letter. If you want the number 2 here, then you have to give that as an optional argument here. Yeah, and finally, if you want not 2 but some other n, then you give it as an optional argument to square root of x. Optional arguments will come in square brackets. So thirds, so this having square root of third root, fourth root of some complicated thing is also called third, something that we all studied really long ago. All Greek letters alpha, beta, extremely readable. Capital alpha, capital beta, just make the A, B capital, gamma, pi. For example, pi we require for product, just like summation is sigma, capital sigma. Like that product, we need capital pi. Inside math, if you want spaces, I said there is a different complication. So, for little space slash comma slash colon for little more space, for more space semicolon, quad and double q, really much more space. If you want two equations on the same line inside equation mode, negative space is also possible. Yeah, that's very important. Slash exclamation mark. Yeah, I didn't know. In fact, that there are these other spelt out these commands also, but these are the shortcuts that one uses. You can also use slash exclamation mark 3-4 times one after another. Then it'll become more and more negative spaces. Yeah, this sort of completes math mode. The strength of LaTeX is that math mode is extremely easy. Really complex big matrices, submatrices, they all can be specified in a very easy way, very easy readable way. So our next topic is bibliography. So bibliography also works fairly similar to lists, only that bibliography now has there are different ways of bibliography. IEEE uses 2-3 styles. Different companies use different ones, because of which bibliography is a special list that has different way of calling it. Also, in bibliography, sometimes you want to cite a particular reference. You also want to at that time put the page number where this particular statement occurs in a book. Yeah. So these are things that are extra required in bibliography, which are not required for general label refs. So the bibliography is the environment that provides a clean and simple way to add bibliography to LaTeX documents. Begin the bibliography, end the bibliography. Yeah, is allowed to have maximum the width of the label. You don't have you don't you please don't worry about the maximum width of the label, it is relevant for only certain types of certain styles. So, each item in the bibliography is similar to an item in a list, yeah, we already saw. Bib item label, this label is an optional thing that is not relevant for general lists. Bib item and the name, this particular name is what we will refer to in the content in the document. Bibliography typically comes at the end, wherever you write the bibliography it will come there, yeah. But we want to refer to, let us say, the fifth item in bibliography. So, bib item, whatever label, whatever name, sorry, whatever name we have here, that name we will say slash cite name, yeah, cite for citation. So, you cite that particular name in the content of in the document, yeah, that is how you will get the number of this bib item inside this number. If you use a different style file, then you can get the first letters of the authors. There are different ways of doing this. Let us stick to numbers for the time being. Again, like any typical label ref combination, bib item cite combination also requires you to compile twice. First time the numbers are generated, and second time they are all available for citing in the text of the document. We can see an example about this before we go to the very important topic about Beamer. So, let us go back to, so we will remove unnecessary things here. Here, so here we have something called cite pylab. This is the name we have given, yeah. Nobody will know what item you, what name you had given to this particular site. Let us go to where that pylab has been called, yeah. Look, in bib item there is one bib item called pylab, it does not have any optional argument, there is no label, there is no pylab is what this entire thing will be called, this information will be called as pylab. When you cite it in the text, then whatever number gets allotted to this particular bib item, that number will appear there. How did it know that it should put numbers? Yeah, so some bibliography style can be specified. If you do not want numbers, numbers happens to be the default in article. If you do not want this, if you want some other way, then you can also choose bibliography style by using the command bibliography style. Let us compile this. So, I am not doing this slowly because there is enough in this tech file, but we are interested in references, yeah. So, notice that bib item pylab has occurred the second here, yeah. It says, so there is some particular style of putting these references, or name of the author, then the title of the document, title of the paper. If it is a journal, then the journal name comes in italics, then the volume of the journal, the issue number, the pages. Some people also put the month and the year, month explicitly, and this is some DOI that may or may not be required to be put, yeah. So, if you use bibliography, then automatically this reference word has got generated, it is put there, it might come into the table of contents also. That depends on whether you are using book or report. If it does not come, you can always put it by using add to contents line command. So, let us, this number 2 could easily become number 3 if you add another reference in the middle, yeah. So, that number 2 should be called very carefully using cite command. So, let us look where we had called it. So, I already missed it. Yeah, it happened to be here inside the appendix. This number 2 has come because we gave bib item, that particular bib item where we want to cite this as a particular name, and we cited the same name. Yeah, what name you choose is not important, yeah, some other name. Because, yeah, this particular item, if you use this some other name, you can just as long as you call the same one, number will be the same. Yeah, it is just some internal referencing, cross referencing. So, we gave a new name and the first time compiling it has given a question mark here. Let us compile again. So, now the number 2 has come. Yeah. Why did number 2 come here? Because it happened to be the second one in the bibliography list. This happens to be number 3. Let us see what this 3 is. There is a third one, another site called IPy. It is good to give some suggestive names, some other name. This is an extremely bad way of numbering, labeling, bad way of choosing names for either bib item or labels. Yeah. So, one should give very suggestive names, and the first name was PyLab, and that is indeed a good name to give. Let us see what is the site IPy. Site IPy name happens to be here, here, bib item name. Yeah. So, this is how one uses bibliography, and after this of course, there is a end document. So, that completes bibliography, this was extremely important. How to cite more than one reference in the same line? Yeah. Somebody has asked, how to cite multiple ones? Let us see this. So, here you can easily type same line, I think he means inside the same square bracket. Same line is of course possible, because that would not be a problem anyway. Some other name inside the same square bracket, you can put comma and put these other things, it will come in the same sequence. Here 3 has come first and then 2 has come. Yeah, this particular space it has left. You did not have to say that. Somebody has asked how to link citation. Link, I guess the question is hyperlink. You link this and automatically it will get connected to the web, maybe. Yeah, for example, DOI is also a permanent link. You might want, the question perhaps is how to link the citation. This is also very much possible. You have to, again, you have to use hyperref in the PDF file. If you want to link one to another within the same PDF file or to the web, you have to use hyperref package. This is what I had typed earlier before, but that is not part of this course. The last important topic we have to cover is to use the beamer. Yeah, how to make presentations using beamer. So, hyperref package will also help in, when you click a citation, it will go to the reference. It will also put where all, which all pages the citation has been referred to. These are all possible. Okay, now let us start this important topic called beamer. Beamer is a separate package that runs on LaTeX. Yeah. So, if you have a presentation, again to compile it, you will use PDF LaTeX. So, use beamer. Why use beamer now? Why not? You have written the entire document in LaTeX and now will you shift to OpenOffice? No. Why? Because all your math, all your LaTeX code is directly usable in Beamer. Yeah, if you have written the document, if you have written a report in LaTeX already, now you have to make a presentation about that report. It is best to do it in something that is very well compatible with Beamer, with LaTeX, and Beamer is an example. There are others also which are used for making packages. Beamer is a relatively recent phenomena. There used to be Prosper, there used to be Tech Power, there used to be something called SlideTeX also, overlays, SlideTeX, various have been there, but Beamer is by far the most flexible, the most powerful in my opinion of late. It is recommended that you start with one of the Beamer templates. Yeah, let us look at speaker introduction template. So, document class, it is not report, it is not proceedings, proc, it is not article. It is not book, it is Beamer now. So, it will automatically look for Beamer packages. Yeah. So, please ensure that you have installed Beamer packages before you try to do PDF LaTeX. Beamer also does not come in the default one. So, Beamer, the content is divided into slides. Yeah, that is the important difference, and material cannot spill from one slide to another. In a document, you want the material to all be written up and automatically it will go from one page to another. It will continue from one page to another, and that is why for tables and figures you have to do something about it. But for Beamer, all the content is automatically is manually divided into slides. Yeah, Beamer will not do this automatically for you. Second is you have to use some theme. Theme meaning what? For example, look at the slides that we are using. On the top there is some name of this topic here. There is something else here, presentation Beamer. Yeah, notice below that there is an author name here. Please look at this mouse, this pointer. There is also some topic, the title of this presentation. There is something about page numbers here. Inside this, you will notice that these are all actually hyperlinks. In the PDF file, these are all hyperlinks. What is seen here? One can go to next page, one can rotate the, one can zoom from within the PDF file. So these possibilities are there because of a particular theme being used in Beamer. So the use theme is used to do about that. Now the most common is Warsaw. There are several themes. The easiest that we can do is we'll give you the tech file for our slides. Yeah, you can have a look at that. Is also been made in Beamer only. One can also use some color themes. Important is begin frame, title of the frame, subtitle if you want two things to come there, and finally the end frame. Whatever comes between these is the content. Yeah. If this particular slide contains something that's like verbatim, LST listing, then there is something called fragile. Yeah, I recommend that don't worry about fragile. Wherever it is said, you put the fragile, just put it. It is harmless to put fragile in any case. What is this fragile exactly? See, these are all environments. LST listing is an environment. Verbatim is an environment. Begin equation, end equation. All these are different types of environments, and there is generally speaking some compatibility problems between these environments. And in such a case you have to resolve it, and that is when you specify something called fragile. Yeah, so it is best to just call it fragile. Nothing will go wrong for all basic things. You can also put content and make it come little by little rather than all of it come together. You can make it come in bits and pieces. You can make it come, one particular sentence comes in this slide, next time you press pause it will you press the space button, next slide it will not be there. Yeah, so all this is possible by using slash pause. These are all called overlays. So what all is achievable in Beamer, there is no end to it. Like the complete capability is not going to be easily utilized by us people. Yeah, so I already showed some examples of what was done in Beamer in the morning. The set of these slides are also are done in Beamer only. Yeah, so this completes all the content. Somebody's question on chat is, the Beamer output does not display numbers for figures, tables or references. To the best of my knowledge, it puts figures, numbers, but maybe the fragile option is required to be put. So in Beamer one can very comfortably put equations, figures, tables. It is also true that in a presentation there are less number of tables, less number of figures. Cross referencing is not so relevant here, because people will not do this by themselves. You are always going to be presenting it. So to some extent some things are not working is possible, but I have not heard of this problem before. Are there any questions? We can take up questions both on chat and using the hand raise button. There were also some questions. While you ask the questions, let me answer the questions that were on chat. Somebody has asked that when you are making a figure, sometimes we have a figure 1.1 A, B, C. Yeah, so one can have multiple figures. One can have figures kept beside each other. That is possible. That's a little advanced thing, but we are not doing that in the course. But I have done this myself. It is not difficult. Another thing is, you can have inside a big table, you can have one particular entry itself a table. Yeah, array is also very useful for this. Begin array, end array can help you achieve many of these things. Do you have a, somebody asked, do we have a spelling facility of spelling check in content writing? Somebody has asked, can you check the spelling of what content you are writing? So this is something the editor provides. Yeah, I use the Vim editor, and the Vim editor allows you to show wrong spellings, correct the spelling, include it into one's own dictionary, personal dictionary. So please note that this making the PDF file has been split into three separate things. One is content is put in, is going to be put in using a editor, plain text editor. Then there is a PDF LATEX command that takes the text file and makes a PDF file out of it, and then the PDF file will be viewed by using a document viewer. Yeah, the fact that these three things are separate is really a big advantage. Yeah, as I said, all these integrated development editors cannot reach that advantage. So editor is the one that will provide you the spelling check facility. So please show us one slide presentation using Beamer. So the entire this presentation tech file is what we'll make available. Yeah, I think that should be more than enough. That's plenty of pages, 53 pages to be precise, because at the bottom of the slide it says 53. Somebody has said if there are multiple references, if there are many references, and you want it to go to multiple slides, then Beamer will not do it. Yeah, because unlike report, article, these floats are a problem. You have to split it where you think and start it on another one. But table also, I said, cannot be split across pages. Long table is the one to be used for making a table continue from one page to another, especially if you have a table that doesn't fit on a full page at all. So I think I have answered all the questions on chat that have been asked on chat. So the question was, what is the difference between cite and ref? So cite is to be used only for bibliography. That is where the label comes as bib item. Yeah. So this they are like a pair. So label ref is one pair of one for defining the label, the other for referring to it. Like that, bib item and cite again form a pair. Bib item will define the name, and cite will cite the name. Yeah, so in bibliography, the bibliography, that is first of all a list that is has to be very versatile, because different formats are there. Some people want the cite to come in the sequence in which you cite it. Some other publishing agencies want some first letters of authors to come. Because of these differences, they have provided this bibliography style. The bibliography is an environment that is not label ref, but it is bib item cite. Yeah, so in the context of bibliography, bib item and cite is what you have to remember, and it works very similar to label and ref, which you will use for all other counters. Somebody has asked, how do you place a block of text next to a picture inside a presentation? You typically want to have a picture, have some text beside it. Also, I showed some examples of a presentation where you had blocks of text beside each other. They were like individual pages. Mini page can help you do this, but in Beamer you can also use begin columns, and you can have left side column, right side column. You can specify the column width. One of the columns can actually be a picture. So more example about this in Beamer in slides is hard for us. We can put up some example text files on Moodle, so that you can compile them yourself. Ensure that use package Beamer package has already been installed. You can compile it yourself, and we'll give you some very simple templates. From the template itself, you can guess what's going on. Yeah. If there are no more questions, we should stop now.